Morning. Some of you keen followers will notice we are saving you from my wallpaper this week. No need for the shades. The wall is back. Do you remember Shirley Valentine when Shirley had no one to talk to but the wall? Do you feel like that sometimes in your business, that there's no one there to listen? Your family thinks you work too hard, your friends in PAYE jobs think you're mad, and you don't really have a lot of people to talk to? It can be a lonely place running your own business, can't it? You may or may not know, I'm a member of the Entrepreneur Circle. It's an organisation to support SMEs in the UK. And I'm well aware it's pretty Marmite. You either love it or hate it. I really enjoy it. One of the best things this team does is it provides us with a platform and a network of like-minded individuals, a community, no less, with which to speak to and bounce ideas off of and to empathise with. And it's important. There are days when what we're trying to do can seem impossibly hard, when your team are driving you berserk, your clients are unreasonable, and your marketing's not working, your bank balance is looking treacherously low. Allow this to go round and round and round in your head, and you can find yourself making bad decisions. Find yourself talking to the wall, and you need a little help. You need to find yourself a group of trusted advisors, not a wall. There are a few caveats or top tips or whatever you might want to call them for this, so I thought I'd share them with you. Make sure the people that you go to for advice know what they're talking about. Lots of very general audience are about as ill-informed as your Aunt Nellie, so stick to listening to those with relevant experience. Aim high. Hook up with people running bigger, better, more successful businesses. You perform up to your peer levels, so keep your peers aspirational. Diversity is good. Different sectors, different target markets, input from different industries can be really good for your business. And there's also a few things to remember. Don't just accept all advice blindly. You must apply your own filters and values and select what is best for you and your business. Act within your own moral code. If it doesn't feel right, don't do it. Regardless of how legal or productive your advisor's advice may be, if it doesn't fit with you or your company ethics, it's a no. Beware of the consensus effect. Do you know what I mean? Like the TripAdvisor and Facebook, for example, attract a certain kind of review and feedback, and it ain't necessarily the facts. It's a proactive audience liable to respond to excellence or hideousness, and there's no median, so you're in the danger of getting a warped perspective. And people who rely on like Facebook friends anyway, well, you know who I mean, you know, I'm talking about finding your real business buddies here, people that you'd have lunch with, people that would help you weather a storm. These relationships can take years to foster. I have 5 key people that I can call on when I need some input, all entrepreneurs in my industry, in completely different industries, small business, high profit, mega business, low profit, a group of trusted advisors that I can go to when I need to talk to. Instead of talking to my wall, they give me the most valuable feedback, which helps my business grow. And it's really important to get it out of my head, to test it, to listen to it being chewed over, to support me in my decision-making processes. And conversely, even when you've made it, whatever your idea of made it is, remember to give back. Remember the people who helped you along the way, and reserve a little of your precious time by way of karmic thanks who helped you find your trajectory. Go find your mates. Bye.